So De Broglie wave equation is lambda h equal to h by m v. H by, now we can compare two wavelengths, lambda 1 by lambda 2 is equal to m2 v2 by m1 v1, v2 by v1. Lambda 1 by lambda 2 is equal to m2 v2 by m1 v1, or v2 by m1. Momentum v2 by v1. From this we can calculate the kinetic energies. Lambda is equal to h by root 2 k into n. Lambda is equal to h by root 2 k into n. This is the formula which relates wavelength and kinetic energy. Formula which relates the wavelength and kinetic energies. From here again we compare the kinetic energies to wavelengths and to kinetic energies. You can do all these things. Next one is Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Delta x into delta p greater than or equal to h by 2. This is Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Delta x into m delta v is equal to h by 2. Okay? Delta x into delta p greater than or equal to h by 2 pi. Delta x into delta p can be written like this. M delta v is equal to h by 2. So delta x is uncertainty in position. Uncertainty in position. If delta x equal to 0, then delta p become infinity. Delta p is the uncertainty in momentum. If delta p is equal to 0, then delta x become principle to follow electronic configuration. This topic also important. And quantum numbers, basing on quantum numbers, there will also the questions. Basing on quantum numbers, so many questions are asked in previous exams. So first we will look at the rules to follow writing the electronic configuration. Rules to follow electronic configurations. First rule is Argo principle. First rule is Argo principle. What is Argo principle? Electron first enters into lower energy orbitals. After that, electrons then enters into higher energy orbitals. Electron first enters into lower energy orbitals. After that, electron then enters into higher energy orbitals. That is about Argo principle. To find out the energy order, you have to follow N plus L rule. To find out the energy order, you have to follow N plus L rule. While following N plus L rule, you have to take two cases. N plus L rule. Case 1, case 2. So what is this case 1? Orbitals with less N plus L value associated with less energy. Orbitals with less N plus L value have less energy. Case 2. If two orbitals have same energy, then electron first enters into lower energy orbital which have less N value. If two orbitals have same N plus L value, then electron enters into orbital which have low N value. For example, we will look at some of the examples. 3B. Two p orbitals are taken. Find out the n plus l values. Here n is principal quantum number. This is principal quantum number 3. L is the azimuthal quantum number. For p orbital, l value is 1. So it becomes 4. Now come to this 2p orbital. L is 2, p is 1. How much is this one? So first electron enters into less N plus L value orbital. So first electron enters into 2p orbital. After that electron enters into 3p. So first electron enters into 2p. After that electron enters into 3p. Now look at it here. This one. 4s and 3p. This is 4 plus s orbital 0, 3 plus 1. atom less n. So electron first enters into 3p orbital. Electron first enters into 3p orbital. Then electron enters into 4s orbital. Okay. So this is about principle quantum number. So what is this Hund's rule? Hund's rule or Hund's rule, you can pronounce either way. So what is this Hund's rule? Pairing of electrons takes place after each orbital is filled with at least one electron. Pairing of electrons in subenergy level takes place after each orbital is filled with at least one electron. So pairing takes place after half filling of orbitals. Next, Pauli's exclusion principle. So what is this Pauli's exclusion principle? An orbital accommodates only two electrons. An orbital accommodates only two electrons with opposite spin. An orbital accommodates maximum number of two electrons with opposite spins. So that is about Pauli's exclusion principle. So based on electronic configuration, there is a question is there. When 4f level of an atom is filled, the next electron enters into. When 4f level is filled, then electron enter into. The options, first option 5s, second option 6s, third option 5d, fourth option 5p. So when 4f level is filled, then electron enters into. We are asking after 4f in which orbital electron is going to enter. So 4f, use the n plus l rule. N is 4, l. For s orbital, l is equal to 0. For p orbital, l is equal to 1. For d orbital, l is equal to 2. For f orbital, n is equal to 3. So you get the sum. So here two articles have same position. So in such cases, now the electron enters into which articles? Look at least one. So already 7 is completed. So here this one also article 7. So 4F is completed, then it enters into 5D. Which d orbital does not have the 4 lobes? You know that d orbitals So which d orbital does not have the 4 lobes? This d z square does not have 4 lobes. Does not have the 4 lobes. Next. Here one question is, correct set of 4 quantum numbers for the valence electron. Correct set of 4 quantum numbers for the valence electron. Potassium 90, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. So this is the potassium electronic configuration. They are asking which set of the 4 quantum numbers for the valence electron. So this is the valence electron of potassium. Let's write down the 4 quantum numbers. Here this is L. N is equal to 4. This is L. For S orbital, L value is 0. If L is equal to 0, M also 0. Spin quantum number plus on. So these are the 4 quantum numbers of valence electron of potassium. 4 quantum numbers of valence electrons of potassium. some more.